Press the bell icon on YouTube and don't miss another update.
The Indian and Pakistani delegations met on Sunday to discuss the crucial Kartarpur corridor, and from what it seems, some of the differences may have been sorted out. But has that really happened, and what are the remaining points of contention? That's what we're looking at in Government Matters today with me, Ruhi Tewari. Nayanima Basu, who tracks diplomacy for us, is with us in the studio today to tell us what really happened in the meet and what's going to happen going forward. Nayanima, to begin with, we'll go issue by issue and we'll discuss each of them separately. But if you were to, in two lines, describe the talks yesterday, would you say they were positive or would you say status quo has been maintained?
Well, I would say the talks that happened yesterday in Pakistan were extremely positive. And the first round that happened in India on March 14th, we had just given a proposal and yesterday we could cover most of them.
Right. So just for the benefit of our viewers, if you could explain what this Kartarpur corridor is all about, and then we'll go on to talk about the various issues and how many have been sorted and have not been sorted.
Well, Ruhi, the Kartarpur Sahib corridor is basically the birthplace of Guru Nanak Dev Ji, and
that's near Lahore.
Near Lahore, yes. And which is why there has been this proposal for a long time now. It was former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee who had said that why not have a corridor between Dera Baba Nanak corridor, the shrine in Gurdaspur district of Punjab, and let's connect it with Kartarpur Sahib corridor, that is the Narowal district in Pakistan. So have a linkage
right
between the two, so that at least the Sikh pilgrims can go to the holy site.
Right.
But India now wants pilgrims of all faith to attend it.
Right. So in yesterday, of course, a lot of issues were taken up, but one key issue was the number of pilgrims that can go every day. What happened with that? What was the outcome?
Well, India had been from the very beginning suggesting that let's have 5,000 pilgrims go there on a daily basis. And the fact that a corridor should be open from dawn to dusk and 365 days of the year. So Pakistan has agreed as of now, although they have not stated officially, that they are okay with the 5,000 numbers going there daily. However, India wants a proposal, and it has already given a proposal, that on special occasions, about 10,000 additionally over and above the 5,000 on a daily basis.
Right.
And also 15,000 can use the corridor on special occasions. Now that Pakistan has said that will depend on the space availability, the capacity that they will be building.
Right. So essentially we are talking about no visa travel for Indian passport holders and OCIs.
Yes. So Indian nationals and also persons of Indian origin having OCI cards, they will have visa-free travel. That is one very crucial point that got covered, is that they will be allowed visa-free travel. And also the fact that there will be no payment, no fees that these pilgrims will have to be, they'll be paying. Pakistan was saying there has to be some kind of payment mechanism, but I think that also got sorted.
Right. Now, another issue was, which, earlier also has been a bit of a contentious issue, was the bridge on the Pakistani side to ensure all weather connectivity. So what has happened with that? Has Pakistan agreed, and to what extent have they agreed?
So yes, I mean, the Ministry of Home Affairs and the Ministry of External Affairs, they've given a proposal on, given a detailed analysis of the flood situation there, because the Indian side lies on the slope of the Ravi River. So Pakistan has understood that, and they have agreed to build a flyover connecting, because India is also building a flyover there till the international border, from where Pakistan will be building their flyover. But they've given an in-principle approval. Earlier they had suggested let's build a causeway, which India has said will not be that feasible. So
right.
I think that maybe they will not be able to build the bridge by when the corridor will begin, that is November of this year. But eventually they will.
So they've given an in-principle nod to the idea.
Yes, yes. Right.
Now, a very delicate issue is the entire talk of making it a safe and secure corridor, and the pro-Khalistan aspect comes into play. India submitted a dossier, from what I understand, to talk about this as well. So if you can just take us through that, what was talked about and what eventually has been the outcome?
Right, Ruhi. So you are correct that India has given a dossier giving a detailed analysis of not just pro-Khalistani separatists, but also other terrorist organizations and individuals that can pose a threat, while the pilgrims are moving to the entire corridor. So India has reiterated again yesterday's meeting that security remains a very high concern. That's the topmost concern. And Pakistan has given an assurance that, you know, the issue started when Pakistan created a 10-member committee which had people like Gopal Singh Chawla,
right,
pro-Khalistani leader. So Pakistan has said that they have removed
that committee to oversee the corridor.
Yes, right. Yes, that's right. But then that committee has been now revamped. However, concerns still sort of remain, and MHA, the Ministry of Home Affairs, they have taken it up with Pakistan very clearly that they have to address the security concerns. Not just the Khalistani separatists, but also other terrorist organizations should be
right
under control.
So if there are more contentious points left, what would you say they are?
Well, the contentious points at this point of time, what the Ministry of Home Affairs said yesterday, that almost all issues got covered, apart from little technical issues which can be handled at the technical level by the engineers and flood experts and other things. The number of pilgrims remain a big concern, in the sense not really a concern, but how much Pakistan will be able to handle, and the fact that whether Pakistan will be allowing people from all faith to use the corridor.
Because that's what India is pushing for.
Yes, not just Sikhs, but you know, everybody. So Pakistan is yet to come out clearly on that, what they want.
Right. Nayanima, before we close, one final question. How do you view these talks and the fact that, as you mentioned, several creases have been ironed out in the context of larger Indo-Pak relations at this point, which have been turbulent for a while now?
Well, India has said clearly that we are moving on this Kartarpur corridor talks because this is something that concerns pilgrims, concerns a particular faith, and the fact that this is places of worship. But that is not to be construed and not to be interpreted as seeing that both sides have resumed the dialogue, which has been stalled for over 2.5 years.
Right.
The Balakot incident is fresh in everybody's mind. Post the Pulwama attack. So India has said again and again, we don't see it as resumption of dialogue, and neither does Pakistan. They know very well that this is not a resumption of dialogue. That issue is separate, but then it is quite heartening to see at least they are moving on the Kartarpur corridor talks.
Right.
So yes, right. It's a good and positive movement.
Right. Well, good and positive movement is what Nayanima says. Several differences as far as the Kartarpur corridor is concerned have been sorted out. But as she mentioned, this does not mean that there has been a full-scale resumption of dialogue between the two countries. Thank you so much for watching Government Matters. We'll be back with more tomorrow.